again, everybody, and thank you for hanging on, those that have hung on. Welcome, Derek. Derek Chan, I noticed you you pop up while I was just getting myself ready there. Thank you for being there. What are we up to? Where do we get to? I can't remember. Yeah, very interesting first half anyway. It's we're working on Bill and his new bride, Liberty Lee Gates. Jimmy, welcome back again, mate. Thank you. And hi yourself. I think when I was clicking around, I might have cleared the chat. So if anybody did say anything while I was away, which was of ultra importance, which I've missed, then I do apologise. It's me. Put it down to an age thing, you know. Likes to click mouse with hit hands. I got the shakes, you know, yeah, that's me, that's the way it is. So Complexity, good afternoon to you. Oh dear, what's happened here? Da 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 da, he's still learning. I'll put that off, take that off pause now, because it's exactly where we left it before. Guy in a pink bike, welcome back. Thank you very much. I don't know what to do actually afterwards. I'm waiting for some suggestions as to what are the game I could play. What are the games you think I might like? I'm not necessarily saying yes, I'll do them, but I'm not saying no, I won't either. I don't think I could play the sort of thing that Donut plays, Forbidden Donut 440, I think it is. But I couldn't play that. It's just a bit too violent for me, and too fast moving. And Sophie as well, the one you play is a bit probably a bit heavy for me, if the truth be told, because it's just not that sort of thing I do. Shelley, welcome back, good to see you again. I was just asking for people to give me some ideas what they might like to see me playing, or what I think I might even get a grip of playing. Have Minecraft, we can do Minecraft, or we can do maybe World of Warcraft in the future, not just now. Mimo, what kinds of games do you like? Do you know, it's Mimo, that's half the problem. There's so many games. I've got a stream account and I've got some games on stream, but you think, oh, I don't really want to do that, because some of them are a bit boring, to say the least. And other ones, I'm afraid, I just admit defeat and say they're too complicated. So, yeah, you're quite right in asking that question. What sort of games do I like? I don't know. My son and wife, both gamers, and my other son, who's lives a bit further down the road, he's always saying, do this and try that. And they get these bundle packs. Humble Bumbles, I think they're called, and they pull out games and they see them playing and think, oh, I wouldn't mind having a go at that, and then you find you've got to pay £2 million a game or something silly like that, which maybe I haven't quite got that much. You know what I mean. But yeah, I don't know, I'm looking out for another game. So if anyone sees one of these nice passive games, and I don't like Stardew Valley either, a nice passive game where you haven't got to kill everybody all the time. Don't mind shooting the odd bad guy, you know, or if there's a zombie comes up, I'll take him out if you want me to. The odd creeper. Jibite sees V. Hello, welcome. I suspect Jibite sees V. Here's probably an overseas visit to where we stream. We stream from Lincolnshire in the UK, and I suspect there's a bit of Dutch there, maybe. Netherlands? Maybe I'm wrong. But thank you very much for the follow. Don't starve together. I've seen that now, Shelley. That's one I have seen. My wife has played that for a while. I don't know about that. It seems like as soon as you get anywhere in the game, you die, and you've lost everywhere where you got in the game. Which is the way it would be, isn't it? You'd lost everything. That's not the game. Raymond. Ooh, I don't know Raymond. I'm going to write that one down. Who's that? That's Mimo. Thank you, Mimo. Just make sure I spell it properly. Yeah. Raymond. I will look into these games. If anyone makes suggestions, I promise faithfully, I will go and have a look at them after I've finished streaming. And, you know, I don't know them all. It's, It's just one of those things we have to do, isn't it? Ton of strategy games out there as well. Age of Empires, I've seen and played Age of Empires. SimCity, I've got. City Skylines I've actually got as well, but I'm not over keen on it, to be honest. You can change the intensity, yeah. Are you from Austrian? You call me Adolf? Not sure about it. Danke schön, Adolf. Wie geht es Ihnen? I hope everything is well with you anyway. Austrian. That's as good as German as you can get. Oh, I shouldn't say that, should I? That's bad. That's bad talking. Austria. Yeah. I've never not been to Austria. I've been all places around it, Germany, etc. and so forth, but never actually got to go to Austria. Did you get the message I sent you? Oh, to talk about what it says. Okay, I didn't. Where would I get messages from? Let me look on this, Shelley. I have my message, I think, when where I sent. I said thanks to you, but laters maybe, yeah. So much to learn, you know, about this, the layout of windows and bits and pieces you can do. Sort of out of my depth, I think, a lot of the time, and it sort of shows as well occasionally when. Yeah, when somebody doesn't know the way around, and you think, oh, this bloke's a bit of a, what, isn't he, how's he managing, you know, and it's a massive learning curve, which I don't mind. I honestly don't mind the learning curve. It's just, it all seems to come at once, I feel. So, yeah, no worries. You might give me a hint on what it pertains to, Shelley. That would be, interesting. Earlier, do you mean, or what? The incident earlier, or is there something else? I don't know. Anyway, right, here's the Gates family. Let's get back to gaming again, because I think that's what it's about, isn't it? It's gaming. Gibite CV. Mein English ist nicht gut. Meine Deutsch ist nicht gut. As I say, if you want me to talk a little slower. Adolf, that's fine. I really don't mind, and I take my hat off to you for trying. But danke für folgen. I think that says it all, doesn't it? Thank you for following me. Oh, it's something on my stream. Okay, it's nothing bad. Okay, no worries. I don't know where to look for messages. Actually, I'm looking. Got the one where I said thanks to you for supporting me. That was, but I haven't got anything else. Right. We'll sort it out later on. I can't see what to do. Ah, right. Okay. Right. Let me run this past you just for the new visitors. It's we have here. A very tired looking Liberty Lee Gates. She is married to Bill Gates, and unfortunately Bill has come on hard times. He lost his money. I'm not going to go into how he lost his money, because he doesn't want me to tell you, but he did lose his money. She's tired, poor girl. Go and get to bed, go have a sleep. There you go. If you're not already doing that, do that. Yeah, he lost his money, and it's our job now. At least I've taken the responsibility of trying to raise 1 million simoleons for him. We'll do that. I don't know where to look, Shelley. I really don't. I've looked on the little. I'll show you that. I've looked on this bit here, which I'm not going to open up, obviously. So, what? Ah, right, okay, I didn't know that. Okay, we'll have a look. No, it's not there, because there's messages on the Twitch, which I can't see it. Markers red, that's just one I had from yonks ago. No, Oh, well. Email? Hey?
Would it go to email?
I don't know. I don't think I've given... I have an email address that people can use, but I don't want to broadcast it. I'll just... I'll do a PM for it, I think, and we'll see. Danke. How good is your German? Meine Deutsch ist nicht gut. Ich spreche nur wenig Deutsch. It's about, I think that's used up twice as much as I actually know in German. But not to worry. Not to worry at all. If you want me to speak slow, that's good. Under messages. Learn. I need to do that. There's a little button there that says learn more, and that's where I ought to be concentrating or spending my time on. We'll get back to it, Shelley. Don't worry, girl. Right. Where's Bill? Bill's there. He's getting himself some food because I think he will be off to work very shortly. If you want, is it going to be embarrassing? Am I going to be really, really embarrassed, and I might have to hide my head in shame? I sincerely hope not. Now, you wouldn't do that to me. I sincerely hope nobody'd do that to anybody. I notice your wife. Will you introduce your wife to us at some point? She's always there to help. She's basically part of the stream as well. Oh, well, there you are. Do you want to be introduced to the people? She says no, she doesn't want... Right, Deb, or Darabelle, whichever you want to call her, she is intensely shy. That's not... ich kann... Wissen ist gut. Es nur ist... Wissen ist gut ist. Oh, stream break image. Is there really? Okay, that's not embarrassing. That's just me trying to rush it. It isn't a bad word I've typed, is it, Shelley? Oh, no. I'll be back in the effing minute. Oh, dear, that would be terrible, wouldn't it? It's too bad. Maybe she will. Maybe she'll pop on camera one time. I mean, she's exceedingly shy. She's a beautiful, beautiful woman, as you'll see one time. She's what can I say? She's just everything to me, you know. She's just one of those people. We were next door neighbours. I'll tell you the story. I don't mind. I'll tell you the story. I'll embarrass you now. We were next door neighbours, and I was married, and she was married, and she moved into next door to where I lived, and I thought, oh, I like my new neighbour, she's rather nice looking. And, of course, as you do, you're friendly. Her dog jumped into my garden, you know. Right, I've got that, Shelley. I will check that out. Okay, instead of there. Okay, her dog jumped into my garden one day, and I went out and had a look at it, and Fizz was a gorgeous dog. She was beautifully sandy coloured, and I made a fuss of her, and then next door neighbour came out, and she says, oh, sorry about that, he's obviously jumped the fence. I said, don't worry, it's all right. I said, but that gives me a chance to introduce myself to you, and I did that, and I suppose we sort of fell in love over our little fence. It was a day in November, I think, when I had a wall rebuilt which had been damaged, and I invited her around for a cup of tea, and we sort of became very good friends. That's it. That's the story. So she's... thank you for that, Jibite Zivi. So we fell in love, and I haven't fallen out of love with her. It's simple as that. I think everybody... at some time in their life, and this is me getting on the old man hat now, everybody at some time in life will meet the one person they're meant to be with. And I've been married before, and she'd been married before, but we both felt exactly the same about each other. Guy in a pink bike, that's so cute. Okay, it's a true story as well. I'll put my hand on heart to it. But when you do fall in love with somebody, and you get the movie thing where bells are ringing and music's playing and confetti's falling and etc. and so forth, and little hearts popping off everywhere, you know. And that's the way it was for me. It was just like this sudden moment of realization. That's the truth. It, suddenly you realize that anything that you've felt before has never been equaled, and this is certainly superior to everything that you've felt before. And that's the way I felt. And before long, we decided that maybe we should be better off together. So we told our respective partners. The truth we told, I think we were hoping they would get together and it would make it a lot easier for us, but that never happened. And that's the way we went. It may be a nice little love story. Unfortunately, there was a little bit of hurt involved because of our ex-partners. I felt betrayed and upset and all the other stuff, but sum total is that that love that we found in each other and as being next door neighbours has never been equaled or surpassed, so that's the way it is, you know, and I'm dead happy. But unfortunately Deborah is very shy. If I say boo to her, she goes, "Oh, is it all right for me to jump?" And then jumps and out. See, that's what I have to put up with. You witnessed that, all of you. I got beaten up then. Don't you start laughing. Good heavens. Yeah, see, there, look, I've taken it off her now. This is it. She's... Oh, the things I have to live with here. Now, look, see, this is it. I'll show you how long it is. Look. This is it. And it's got this big handle on it that... She grips and hit. Oh, I'm going to hide that away. You? So, Devkite. Yeah, that might be the game you'd like. Okay, oh, well, I'll write that down as well because I've got my Rayman here as well. Develop Dev Tycoon. Yeah, DevTycoon. I will take a look at that. I'm open to all suggestions. So, there we are. Right. Like Spider-Man. Oh, that'd be awesome to be Spider-Man, wouldn't it, eh? Did it from the wrist, you know? Cool. That's what I like. Anyway, Bill Gates, less of my personal, and now taking the focus off Deb, who's wielding the stick again. Now she can put that down. Just put it down. I'm not going to say you. All right, that's it. I promise I won't put the camera on you while you're looking. So there we are. That's we'll move back to the Gates family here. It's going to get me out of trouble, I hope. Like me and Deb, they're very much in love, and they've got their little target they want to meet, and they're going to get out of debt and get Bill out. Well, he's not in debt. They've got 76,000 simoleons now, but we're going to try to get the package in. Bill, what's the matter with you, lad? Oh dear, yeah, so we're going to get him out of debt. We're going to get him a million simoleons that he can, he can go to work on his next couple of million after that. So, I don't know if it's possible. We started it off, GTA 5, Grand Theft Auto 5. That's a bit violent, I think. GTA 5. Maybe, I don't know. From what I know of it, might be. I watched Forbidden Donut playing GTA, and that's a violent game. I don't know which one it is he normally plays, but he can pick people up by the scruff of the neck and have them cut in half in 10 seconds. And I don't think I could go. I'm not that good a gamer. You see, that's the other thing as well. World of Warcraft is great because I quite enjoyed that, and as I say, it's very rare that you go on and kill humans apart from humanoids such as cat purse people and bandits and them sort of people. There's no human types, so when you're killing them, it's like killing zombies. It's sort of acceptable. Minecraft I do play, and I kill the zombies and the creepers and all the rest of them that are in there, and have no problem with it because that's the way it goes. I think it was only last Monday where I showed my little video that I created for the start of my story. Because one thing I do like is having little stories and themes when you're playing a game. And the little story started. I might dig it out in a bit and let you see it yourselves and you decide. I will just advance warn you that there is no... I'm calling out a mayday when I first get there, and there's no panic in my voice at all, you know, the sort of, oh, boringly, well, mayday, mayday, you know, this is it, boring, boring, I'm crashing, oh, boring, boring, done this before, crashing, and that's the sort of theme it takes on, so, yeah. There we go. But keep throwing these games at me, because I don't know them all, and certainly I will look into every one that's suggested to me. as long as it's not sort of silly, you know? Silly. I'll say the word silly. Right, okay. Where are we going now? Jim, Bill, you're off for the weekend, are you, mate? You've got the weekend off, have you? She hasn't got a job. Yeah, he's got a couple of days off. Right, Bill, get yourself into this garden, mate. And get these harvested, because that's money. Liberty, you can come out and get the spray can out, because you've got to spray the bugs. We don't get the gardener on a Saturday. If you could have one stuff pack, which would it be and why? Good question. Which one was that one you recommended?
Stuff or expansion.
Ah, right, stuff pack or expansion, Shelley. I like the one with the gardens in it, the romantic garden, is it? But that's just my nature. Whether I'd enjoy
a stuff pack,
right? Okay. Quite like the idea of that. It would suit my. It would suit me really. Romantic garden stuff pack. Yeah. Okay. So stuff pack can be one. The one with the jobs in it as well, going to work or whatever it is. I don't know if that's an expansion or what, but. That sort of interests me at the moment. I'm going to take a look at that. And in all honesty, a couple of weeks ago, when they were on offer, I'll come back to you, Jibite, in just a second. When they were on offer, I'd saved up some money and put it. I've got a little tin here, which there you go. Looks like this is a little tin I have just to keep my money in. When I get it, it's change extra or some money in my pocket, I'll pop it in there, and when it gets up to enough, as it did, I decided I would pop out and get these a stuff pack and an expansion, the one with the jobs in it, and of course the garden. And I thought, right, I'll go and get them. And when I got there, taking the offer off, so they're twice as much as I wanted to spend on them, you know. So that's me. I'm sort of stuck and lost in that, and a bit disappointed, to say the least. But hey, you know, you get dealt a load of cards, and you have to deal with it, don't you? That's the cards you play. And if you don't like it, shuffle your pack again and see what you get. You know, I've got what's that? I used to say to somebody, to be a person I knew, and they said, you know, how wealthy are you? I said, well, I'm a millionaire. Oh, just a second, Shelley. I'll give you an email address that you can use on the messaging thing, if that's all right. I've got a lump in my throat now. Thank you very much. I'll give you a whisper. I don't know where the whisper's gone, but I'll give you one when I find it. It's twice a year, so don't worry, you'll get another chance. Oh, that'll be brilliant. Yeah, whatever. I should answer no to that. No, they can't. I'll give you a web address that you can use, which will be that. Thank you. Okay, thank you. Right, and I better copy that to somewhere else, hadn't I? Because I'll lose it otherwise. Oh, you put a lump in my throat, Shelley. You shouldn't do that. I'm glad you did, but you shouldn't. Do 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 do. Right. Put it onto there. And save it, because I'll come to it later and wonder what the hell it is. Save as. Yeah, you're an awesome person, you are. Awesome. And I'll just close that as well. So, thank you very, very much. Gosh, you know how to bring a bloke to his knees, don't you? Eh? Yes, wonderful. Thank you very much. I shall get... I'll get something straight away when we're finished streaming this afternoon. Yeah, this happened... It sort of happened once before. I had... the very first day I was streaming, I was talking to a French guy. It was Thomas GUI, and he was very, very chatty and very inquisitive and everything, and he said, what expansions have you got? And I said, well, I haven't got any. Basically, I just can't afford it, but I accept that, because that's the way it is. And he said, well, look, he says, I've just made a donation, and he gave me $10 just out of the blue. I didn't even know 100% that you can get anything like that, but... then of course my mate Justin, he did the same, which it does almost bring me to tears when this happens, you know, because it's just so nice of people. Anyway, right, so I was saying to this person, they said, you know, are you very wealthy? And I said, no, I said, I'm only a millionaire. And they said, well, how come you're a millionaire? I said, well, I got just, it's £1 million I keep in the bank in a hidden bank account. They said, well, use it. I said, well, if I spend a penny of it, I'm not a millionaire anymore, am I? And they said, well, no. I said, well, there you go, that's the reason. I'm a millionaire because I'm rich in heart, I think. I've got a $1 million wife, you know, and she sort of gets on very well with my £1 million wife as well. No, I mean, she's, I don't know. I'm going to play Sims instead. Right, sorted. Ah, dear, spraying the plants. Where do these bugs come from as well? So many of them, isn't there? Bill's decided to knock off. Oh, I suppose really, you know, he's working all week and he's expecting a day off occasionally. I'll get him to water the plants. Wait, come on, Bill. Bill, don't play games. Water the plants. There we go. Hi, right. Have I missed anything? Somebody said something. I'll get back to them. And I think it was G-Byte. Javi, what about Kerbal? That was the one. Kerbal Space Program. I've... All right. Yeah, I did say to Kerbal, to G-Byte that I'd come back to him on that one. So, right. Kerbal Space Program. I quite like the idea of that. There seems a lot to it, and you've got to learn a lot to be able to move on a bit, but I watched Quill18 doing that one afternoon, and I was thoroughly transfixed on what he was doing. Now, whether or not I can work that out myself, I really don't know, but I'll put it on the list, because if things get too tough, I can put all these into a hat and choose one. And I will just say, because people say, oh, everyone says that. If I say I'm going to do that, that's exactly what I will do. I don't sort of, I don't cheat on myself, because I'm the only one that loses out on it. So that's cool. Don't let people see that. Okay. I think I'm up to date with the chat now. Ah, dear. Right. I think I've got everything up to date. Just running up and down my list to make sure I haven't missed anybody since I come back on. Where do we get to now? Right, I'm going to move on. I'm going to leave the Gates family this afternoon, because I've been with them since I started at 2 o'clock, and I'm pretty sure there's other things need doing. So I'm going to save that there, and we'll go to the map and we'll choose another family to have a play with. Jojo with a Bobo. I'm back. Great stuff, Jojo. Thank you for coming back as well. It means a lot when people come back. So, Where have you been? Is the other question, I suppose. Being totally nosy. Manage worlds. Just go to manage worlds. Music! I can hear music. Yeah, that's it's a little saying that I keep just down below on that side where it says bits and pieces and schedules and that. It's my favourite, the favourite saying that I read somewhere one time. It says, do not go where the path may lead, go instead where there is no path and leave a trail. And that is, I think it's really true of many things that you come to in life. It's so easy, isn't it, just to follow the path and you go where everyone else has been and there's no hassles because it's a well-walked path. But to stretch out and reach for that trail that nobody's made, go into somewhere nobody's been before so others can follow you. That's what we call human progress, I think. And if I'm wrong, I apologise, but that is honestly the way I feel about things. Right, let's go and see how Justin is getting on. Did Justin come back? Justin, did you come back? This is your moment now. If you haven't come back, I shall take you off my follow list. That's what I'll do. I'll sulk. I'll be really miserable and sulky for the rest of the day. Because you went to have a nap and a bite to eat, and I haven't heard you speak yet. So, there we are. Anyway, here is Justin. Little Justin is staring. He's staring at his kid. It's Max, Bentley Max, who's a dead ringer for him, actually. Oh, so he walks away when I'm trying to look at him. Yeah, so there's Justin and Justin Jr. I might change him to Justin Jr. It suits him. But it was selected as a Bentley Max. That's what we'll stick with. So forget what I said about changing to Justin Jr. tomorrow, should we? Ah, right, a community garden. Would I know how to do that? That would be from the stuff pack. Yeah, okay. But I'm not streaming tomorrow because, I have other commitments, quite a few actually tomorrow. Busy day tomorrow. Ah, Justin, leave her alone, man. God, you're always there, aren't you? Snogging and kissing. And poor Sophie's, yeah, I don't know, she's got things to do now. She's got responsibilities with Bentley Max. So, yeah, there you go. It would make... Yeah, I need to learn how to do that. So I might... when I get the add-on pack, I will learn it. And then maybe what you're saying there, that I should stream it. He's not, is he? Gosh, I didn't think he was due to go yet because we were playing him day before yesterday. Justin, come on, mate. Come on, you have to go. Yeah, good man. There's dishes need washing or something. He's actually the head dishwasher. Well, he was until he goes into work. Dexicon, well, got to put it there. Absolutely. Yeah, we know what his goal is, well, don't we, Dexicon? Or Dexinon, I should say. Yes, I'll learn how that things work, Shelley, and then by Friday when I stream again, you might have some idea of how to do that. Sunday, I am sort of threatening people that I may do a 12-hour straight broadcast or stream from about 10 o'clock in the morning through to about 10 at night, stopping only for putting the nose bag on, so to speak. So, eh? Oh, and cups of tea as well. I keep getting told off because cups of tea. My wife puts cups of tea down in front of me. I have an orange juice because if talking a lot, which maybe I do, I get a sore throat very easily. So occasionally she'll bring a cup of tea. 9 times out of 10, if I'm streaming, then I have to throw it away because it's gone cold. So this is me drinking tea. Slurping it up and making all those horrible noises. You're doing a multi-twitch with Justin. How would we do that? I don't know how to do that. How would you do that? We could use some sound thing. What was that sound thing we had with Bad Doggy? We tried it out. The voice.
Discord.
Yeah. What's it called?
Discord.
Discord. Yeah, we could get Discord and try that out if Justin was willing. Or I don't know if we could put two streams up together and a split screen. That would be good, wouldn't it? Hey, what kind of tea do I drink? This is Tetley's tea bags. Tetley's the best tea bags. As a second choice, we would have PG Tips, and as a third choice, we'd have Yorkshire tea. So that's it. I don't like the Lapsang Souchongs and the Earl Greys and the Picos, and I know of them. And I used to work in a supermarket. We had all the whole range of them teas, and they were a nightmare because people say, "Oh, what's this one like? Orange Pico, for example. Oh, what's that taste like?" Read the label, you know. The label says it's orange pico. It tastes of pico nuts. No, oranges. No, I don't. I've never tasted them. I have Tetley tea bag, PG Tips, or Yorkshire tea, and that's as good as it gets. Admit, though, I am new to this site. You are my favourite streamer. And what do you say? Helping me with them. Oh, brilliant, Jebite. Danke schön, das ist gut, ja? Thank you very much, because I would... Both me and Deb will sit here in the evening. There's a French guy who was doing Starview Valley and his commentary. Now, we don't speak French. Twinings, okay. Right, so maybe, Shelley, I'll be teaching you stuff, yeah? You don't get the same tea in Germany. Went back and got myself a box of Irish breakfast tea. It's almost empty. I have to get some more then, Mimo. You have to just get a pen pack. That's what going back to the 60s in the next story. But pen pals, brilliant. That's what it's all about, you know, pen pals. And say, "Oh, hey, Wonder, could you just send me some tea, please? I like that one. I like the Irish tea, please, because it makes me help with the accent and speaking Irish all the time." So, right, Deskin. Twinings, yeah. And Jebite, yeah. As I was saying, we follow this French guy. Now, neither of us speak French, but I'm pretty sure that if we just concentrated on the English version of the game, but what he was saying in French, then we could maybe pick up the odd word or two. And the same with German. Close family knowledge. Yeah, that's it. That's the other way of doing it, of course. Yeah, I had once upon a time, I used to have the Beatles monthly magazine, which none of you will remember, I'm sure. But it used to be a magazine published by the fan club of all the Beatles activities and what have you. And I was a fan of the Beatles. Everybody was a fan of the Beatles at some point in their life. And I would read through this magazine once a month. And one time I went in there and I had a pen pal section in there, and I saw this name, Laurie Anker, her name was, and I thought, "Oh, I'll make her a pen pal. I'll write to her." So I wrote to her, probably along with another 100 million people as well who wrote to her, and I was lucky. I got a response from her, it took a while because she lived in Nashville in Tennessee. 731 Elysian Fields Road, Nashville, Tennessee. There you go, I've given her address out now. So everybody can rush around there and say, "Does she still live there?" Well, I don't think she does, because I sent a few letters later in life and they never got read or returned. But she used to be the niece of Paul Anka, the singer, which... you did. You loved it, right? So you're maybe not still in school. And it's a 2-mile walk. Oh no! Well, go on, Shelley. Cheat. Just run it for a mile and then get back quick. There you go. But you got to do what you got to do. And if you don't get back in time, thanks ever so much for what you've done for me this afternoon. It's really it's melted my heart a lot. So thank you. And you love the Beatle Monthly, mate. You say, "I love it as though it's still in existence." I don't think it's still going, is it? Or do you get back copies and that sort of thing? Anyway, I wrote to Laurie Anker and we exchanged quite a few letters back and forth.
just explaining situations. I was in the Navy at the time, so I had lots and lots of bits and pieces I could tell her. There was also lots of bits and pieces I couldn't tell her as well, but I you know, we used to communicate. And then she says, oh, I'll send you my photograph. And she sent this photograph. Wow, talk about, you know, an angel or whatever. That was what she looked like. Absolutely beautiful looking woman. And that was it then. Hey, you know, nobody's got a chance here in the UK, certainly. But then I had some problems. Had a little fire in the the barracks where I was sort of staying, and I lost a lot of information. And well, it wasn't just me, it was everybody. We lost bits and pieces and personal belongings, but you get over it, you know. It's I didn't have anything that couldn't be replaced. There was no sentimentality apart from all the letters from Laurie, and I never did get back in touch with her. And so as far as she's concerned, she sent me this photograph. It's terrible, this. But she sent me this photograph and never heard from me again. So, you know, if anyone knows of anybody whose maiden name was Laurie Anker and they lived in Nashville in Tennessee, then say, Howard didn't just stop writing to you. It's just something that happened. Mine shuts and, oh gosh, you're testing me, aren't you, G-Byte? Let's see if we can work it out. I'm pretty sure we can work it out because I have a language translator. My school days are overdue. Okay, overdue. No. Yeah. Obfuling. Overdue. Okay. I'm not quite sure how the translation works on that. And please don't think I'm being rude, J-Byte. I wouldn't do that. It actually translates as your school days are overdue, and quite possibly what you're saying. If you remember the Beatles magazine, like mine, my school days are over a long time ago. So, yeah. Oh, look at what's Bentley doing there? I'm sure he was just playing in the rubbish. Bentley, Max, stop it. You're being naughty. Smack your legs. Naughty boy. Oh, go and jump in the puddle now. What's happening to this house? It's falling apart. Justin, where are you, mate? Are you streaming, or are you watching, or what? You need to really... Never mind putting on the sad face and walking with a slump. Just get back and repair the loo when you finish picking up the rubbish. Batsy Boy 75. Oh my gosh, how old are you? Legend. I'm 21. I think I'm 21. Ah. Can you send him a message? You're a bad lad. Howard says you're a bad lad. Go on, send it to him. Go on. Yeah. Just say, Howard says you're a bad lad. I'm 21 and a bit. Actually, I'm 21 three times over. And then there's three more to add on to that. So, Batsy Boy, yeah. I have no shame in saying I'm a 66-year-old old age pensioner, you know. I draw a pension because I'm so old and decrepit now. But why should you young'uns have all the fun? That's what I'm asking myself. Why should young'uns have all the fun? I can... I seem to be able to stream. It's only a matter of talking a lot. By God, I can do that. But yeah, thank you very much for that. It's in the end of the sentence there. Oh my gosh, how old are you, legend? Unless you meant legend as in you were so long ago that you're actually a legend rather than reality. I don't know, but thanks anyway. I hope. You're 53, J-Byte. Okay, that's cool, mate. A bit closer to me than my age than what some of them are. But it's the only thing is, okay, let's look at this age thing. A lot of people have mentioned, I've had trolls coming on, and the funniest one was some guy came on, and, oh, 16, I wish. Some guy came on, first stream I did. And he said, oh, how are you, old man? And he was
I think he was being offensive. But he was slapped down pretty much straight away by a few of the followers I had at the time. One was NMNLJK, who was Joanne, and she sprang to my defence and said, "How rude can you be?" And it ended up, he sort of apologised and didn't mean to be nasty and all these sort of things you say. So it's, age is just a measure of experience, surely. You can be as, how old did you say you were? 16, Dexicon. And of course, Jebite Sivi is 53 years of age. But that is just a measure of the experience you've had in life, isn't it? Whether you're 16, you can be 16 years old and fully experienced in life, and it's where I'd known kids 16, 17 who have had such a rough upbringing in their lives that they're as worldly wise as most 50-year-olds, you know, because they've been through the mill, they've been there, seen it, done it, got the T-shirt, and probably read the book as well. And Batsy Boy, you're 14. Cool. That's 14 years of experience, and this is like I'm saying, that you could be, you're only 14 or 16, however, it doesn't matter how old you are, it's just the measure of experience of life that you've had. I've had 66 years of experience. It doesn't mean to say I think like a 66-year-old, and you know, I mean, the very idea that I sort of look old and decrepit, and I've got this white beard that Santa Claus would be proud of, and do I do modelling for gnomes, etc. You know, I've heard all these, but deep inside, right down deep inside and in the heart, I guess I'm no older than about 20, 25, 27. And you talk to any older person, senior citizen, old age pensioner, decrepit old fogey, whatever you want to call them, you know, you say, well, how old do you feel? And I can bet you any money you like, most of them will say in their 20s or 30s, because you never feel older than that. And am I preaching? I hope I'm not preaching, because old folks do that a lot. That's when you get to my age, you start to feel like, what was the saying? I don't know. What was it? The I was going to tell you a joke that I was told by Forbidden Donut, but judging from the age of people here, I better not tell that joke, because before I do, I'd need to click it up as an over 18s channel. But a good joke which I like about old folks is, there's two old men on the park bench, and one of them said to the other, he says, I feel really old today, I really am, how do you feel? And his mate turns to him, he says, well, I'm like a baby, I feel like a newborn baby, honest. He says, what, you feel like a newborn baby? He says, how's that then? He says, well, he says, I've lost my teeth, he says, I've got no hair, and I think I just pooped. So there we go, that's old age. Yeah, it's not how old are you, it's how are you old. Yeah, that's spot on, mate, that's what I'm saying. So, yes, we could have long conversations on age, etc. But it all boils down, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what age people are and what age they get to. It's how much you enjoy life and living that really matters. I mean, I have got utopia now because I've got a gorgeous wife who's with me all the time. I can spend time with her day and night. Don't have to go anywhere without her anymore. I used to have to go to work, which means that we were separated. And that was terrible, you know, going to work, not being able to see her for however many hours you're away for. And then, you know, suddenly now, here we are, we can spend 24/7 with each other. And I only get beaten a couple of times now, as opposed to most of the time before. So, it's... there we go. She reached for the stick then, I swear. Did you reach for that stick then? Did you? She did. Oh, that's great, Mimo. That's good. The word. Word, man. Word. Peace. Love. Word. Yes, I hope people enjoy the streams. I hope... you know, sitting here and having people... No, let's be honest. Come on, if you got people sitting there thinking, go, she'd shut up, they wouldn't be on this stream, would they? Be somewhere else. So,
tea time. I'm being signalled that I have to drink more tea because it'll be going cold. Excuse me, and if I slurp, I apologise in advance. I'm breaking the teeth in for the dog. Who's PewDiePie? I don't know. Maybe that's a new one on me, but if you had a cool and funny attitude, you would make more subscribers, right? It's probably some guy who's got a few subscribers, I take it. Sorry? Has he really? That'd be good. Are you implying that he doesn't have a cool and funny attitude? Because I would disagree. Well, let's not go to war over this, you know. I would like to get into the position where I have subscribers, because that would be the utopian desire, isn't it, for streaming. I'm flattered. I mean, you know, 6 weeks ago or 5 weeks ago, however many weeks ago it was, okay, right, yeah, 6 weeks ago, if somebody had said to me, you're going to have 100 followers, I'd have still been on the floor laughing, because I didn't think that would be humanely possible for me to get that many. Because, okay, I tell stories, I've always had a bit of a story to tell people. And I enjoy talking, I enjoy telling stories, and I enjoy language as well, which helps, I suppose. Right, YouTubers, okay, I sort of understood that, I think. I wasn't sure if they were Twitchers or streamers, or whether they were YouTubers, but even on YouTube, I've noticed since I started streaming, my followers on YouTube seem to have increased. I think when I first started off, I had about 15, and I thought, wow, I got 15 followers on YouTube, you know, and it's up to about 70 now in a short space of time. So, hey, that's cool with me. I can do this. Turn it into a profession. I noticed people like Quill18, who I mentioned before, and Kiss for Luck, they actually advertise themselves as entertainers, and that's what I feel I'm doing as well on this this game. I certainly don't spend too much time playing it. There's Twicky Carson. What's she doing here? Hello, Twicky. What are you doing? Hey, you come round to borrow a cup of sugar. Oops. There we go. Don't leave her there. Just invite her in. Good heavens. Let's have a look, honestly. And let them who... Baringo. Samba. Yeah, that's perfectly true. I'm so happy that even if it's just a moment or two of joy you can take into somebody's life, I'm glad I'm responsible for that, because that is so so nice, isn't it? It gives you a warm feeling. And I think of all the jobs I've had in the past where I've been in contact with public and, you know, had to do public relations exercises. But it's so difficult. You get somebody coming into a shop because they want to return a faulty disk drive or whatever it is, and you have to be yes sir, no sir, three bags full sir. Whereas the nice thing about Twitch, and I guess YouTube as well, if you do streaming on YouTube, is that you can be yourself and you don't have to yes sir, no sir, three bags full sir. You just tell it the way it is and you speak honestly. As long as you speak from the heart, then then surely that's... I can't get over that name. Pancakes. Who would have a surname of Pancakes? Eh? Is that Mimo of Pancakes? Oh no, I've upset somebody. But no, it's... I really enjoy the streaming. I enjoy it so much. It's unbelievable. And the thing is, and it's quite amazing, that everybody who does streaming... I've spoken to Justin, I've spoken to Sophie... and I've spoken to who else was there? Yeah, there's other ones. I can't bring names to call at the moment. But all the people I've spoken to, they've all said the same thing. It's such a pleasure to sit and talk to people and discuss things without, I don't know, without that adverse reaction you get. You know, like, you're not having
You're not having your money back because it's out of date. You're out of warranty. Oh, come on. Could do without that. See, take your Sims on a retreat and maybe we'll find a bear. I don't know if my Sims can go on retreats because I've only got the basic game. Can I go on retreats on this? No, I don't think. No, it's an add-on pack, isn't it? I won't know. Maybe on Saturday when I do my... On Friday when I do my stream. I might have a bit more fun available then because I have now got an add-on pack. I don't know which one. I haven't chosen yet, but I've been given a code for an add-on pack. And the awesome follower who gave me that had never said which it was for. So that's as big a surprise for me as it is to you. I feel it's probably Gardens, but I sort of hope so, I think. But it's really cool. Not bothered which it is. It'd be really, really nice. So... does my wife play Sims? No, she doesn't. She's yes, it is. She does. She plays. Yeah, she's playing it more since I started streaming, I think. But I rely on her a lot because little things. It's romantic garden. Oh, thanks, Shelley. I thought you was walking your dog. Have I said anything nasty about Shelley in the last half hour? I thought she'd gone walking. I was going to talk about her when she'd gone. wouldn't do that, but thank you. It's that's sort of the one I sort of had in mind. I was going to buy that one when I went there last week or a fortnight ago. So wicked, thank you. But yes, she does say play Sims. She's deep into Warcraft at the moment as well. My second son, he's got a guild, and his girlfriend. She, between them, what you don't know about. World of Warcraft, it's not just not worth knowing. So get heat exhaustion. Oh dear, what sort of dog is it, Shelley? Yeah, what breed is she? And the dog. Yeah. Movie night, okay, Shelley. That's cool. I didn't think. I looked at that one. When it had them up on offer, and I sort of looked at it and I thought, well, that could be a bit limiting, really, but I don't know. It's a husky. Oh, tell my son that. Yeah. Oh, my son would be really envious of you, because we've got a couple of cats. Come back to you, Batsy boy. Japanese Spitz. Wow. Yeah, my son has... always wanted a dog, and we haven't had one because we've got a couple of cats who don't even get on well together, so we have to keep them apart most of the time. But he's determined that when he's finished university and got his own place, he will own at least one husky, if not two. He's so in love with the breed that he says they're so loving and faithful, and they're just absolute pals rather than dogs. So there we go. You have a picture of her on my profile bit. Okay, I'll have a look at that afterwards. Unless you want me to have a quick peek now. Maybe that would be naughty, but hey, I'm into being naughty. Sorry? Can I do that? Okay. Oh, right, okay. Oh, that's wicked. I'm going to drag that across, Shelley. Da-da-da. Then people can see it. There's Shelley's. Shelley's Woofle Hound. Oh, wow. Yeah, two. He says that. He says he can get two. So that's... Have you just got the one, Shelley, or have you got two? Thinking about buying a Newfoundland. That's a country, isn't it, Newfoundland? I don't know dogs. I had a... Who's this? Oh, it's Sophie, what are you doing there, Soph? I should come out to... Well, Annika, come on, Annika, get yourself in there. Annika's one of those neighbours everybody should have, you know. She's... every time I've seen her, she'll go into somebody's house, and I don't know if she's going to do it now, but every place she goes, she always cleans up. She cleans up everything. She's just so fastidious when it comes to the tidiness of people's houses, so it's really good. Oh, right, okay. I had a dog myself some years ago, 20 years ago, the Lord, it's 20 years ago. But I got it from a rescue centre, and she adopted me. It's like our cat. You know, she sort of moved in, he sort of moved in and said, hey, that's it, I'm living here now. You can either get out or share it with me. That was it. But I went to a rescue centre and I saw a dog, and it was cowering right at the back of the cage. It was quite sad to see him. You know, the lump in the throat moment gets you when you see it. But I asked the lady what breed it was, because it looked a bit unusual. And she says, well, it's a corgi crossed with an Alsatian. Right, okay, Patsy boy. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, so it's a corgi crossed with an Alsatian. And I thought to myself, that's just a bit weird. So I sort of tried to entice it to come to the cage door, which eventually it did. And I managed to get a couple of fingers through the chicken wire, well, it wasn't chicken wire fence, but it was that sort of fencing, you know, the cross wire fencing. And I managed to get fingers through, and I started fussing dog's ear roll. And I thought, that is so nice to have the dog push against you when you're fussing it, that's what this dog needs, is a bit of love. So over the course of a couple of weeks, decided that I'd adopt this dog, and it would be probably a good thing for me. Alvin, welcome to the stream there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Great stuff. Is that Alvin CSQ? Right. Alvin CSQ. Why not? So I did. I adopted this dog, and it was spayed and all the rest of it. And what a charm. It was just like... It was just like having a friend. It was a new friend in the family, and, you know, just whatever you wanted it to do, it would do. No objections. It just, all it wanted was just fuss and love, and we had piles to give it. But sadly, it died of cancer in the end, which was one of those things that happen, I guess, somewhere along the line. What is she doing? What is the matter with this girl? Deb? Help? Mayday? Gorba, Ribbo. Okay, I've not seen that before. Right, who was it who asked me a question? Batsy Boy, I think it was. Let me just go back. You asked what recording system I had. I assume you're meaning... come down and read the questions. Right, there we are. Okay, I use OBS, which is the online broadcasting system. Presumably you mean about Twitch and Twitch broadcasting, yeah. And basically the sound, microphone and speakers and that sort of thing is just basically motherboard drivers that come with the computer. Alvin Askew, yeah. That flight glitch. Mm-hmm. Where did you download The Sims 4? I have the disc. I bought the disc originally, and installed it, and then it put me onto this Origin, which controls it. But yeah, it's just a motherboard system that I have for OBS. That's the sound, basically. Nothing supersonic about it. It took me ages actually to work out how you. How you can do it all out. But yes, did I do that with stream? I don't know if it's Steam, I should say. Oh, it does cost a lot, Matsy boy. I don't know whether that's a good question to ask on a stream like this, because there's so many people have spent that money, the money that you're sort of objecting to. It is a lot, and I agree with you, and I can't afford to buy updates on my own, I have to confess. So so is there any way of getting it downloaded? I don't think there is, really. I mean, you can go onto eBay and places like that, where you can get a used copy of it quite cheaply. But yeah, I wouldn't, I don't think it's right to ask how much you can get a freebie version for. So anyway, a very rare game. strong competitors, yeah. Shelley, just wait for the sales. That's right. Ich tut mir leid, Drenhund. After. I have to get a rough translation on that one because I'm not 100% with it. Sorry. Ah, yeah. Thank you for that. Yeah, it was. As I say, it was probably 20 years ago now. So, I've never had another dog since then. I have to confess, never had one. We've had cats since then. Don't know why. Yeah, that's the thing with the game, isn't it? It is attached to an account. But you can get copies on eBay which have been sold. Whether or not the license number works, I don't know. And I certainly wouldn't buy one myself, but yeah. Could you stop pretending to speak German? Who's that? Oh, J-Bite. Is he not German then, or something? What he said is, you know, translatable to I'm sorry about your dog, which, you know, it's nice. Mimo, yeah, so do you know this person? Is it, do you think he's not German or what? Or he's not actually German anyway, I think he said he was Austrian, so let's keep it right. Excuse me, yeah. There we go. Right, where are we getting to anyway? I'm being distracted by all this chat and I have these people here. Sophie is, Sophie's in need of a embrace and a hug, and so is Justin, who's out at work, so he's not doing any embracing or huggery. Little young fella here, little Bentley Max. Oh. Have you done your homework, bud? Class in 12 hours. Not even started his homework. Dear, oh dear. Hunger. Well, I tell you what, bud, I'm afraid, whether you like me or not, you're going to have to go and do your homework. Do your homework. Go on. Go to the table. That's it. Gosh, how much like children is that, eh? Eh? Doesn't want to do the homework. Right, Sophie, what are you going to do? Is there anything needs fixing, anything needs cleaning, anything needs repairing? No. In which case, what time is it? 9:09 p.m. What time is Justin in from work? 11, I think. I think it's 11. Oh, it's 1. Oh, dear. Oh, I'll tell him to... Never mind, everything in the garden is rolling. I share with my sister because she bought it. It doesn't go on it. It's a school. But I bought her expansions. I mentioned to my son the fact, the sociology thing, when I was going to collect him at end of school or end of college, whatever you want to call it. And how... yeah, it's getting personal, I guess I was going to say. Sort of what level of schooling are you at the moment? You don't have to answer that if you don't want to. It's none of my business, and I don't suppose anyone else would want to know as well. So there we go. We'll change subject. How's that, you bite, Civvy? Mimo. Yeah, could have been. I have to say, in his defence, that I tried to translate an earlier statement that he said, and I'll tell you what it was in a moment. He said, my school days are overdue, which had me sort of worrying, because the translation of that doesn't is the sort of thing you'd expect from somebody who's guessing how to say the words. I don't know, and I'm not going to get involved in an argument between who's really Austrian or German or French or Italian or Swedish, Finnish, whatever. I don't know. I'm just grateful for you all to be there, to be honest. I can't see the point of anybody going and pretending they're something they're not, because they're defeating the object of being themselves. And some of the things that J-Bite has said this afternoon would not support the argument that he's a kidder. But hey, what do I know? I don't know these things. Maybe you people have come across each other before on streams. Oh, look at that. Try for a baby. Don't think so. Justin needs all the strength he can get because he's going to make 200 babies on his realm during his afternoon streaming tomorrow, I believe. There we go. How are we doing with money? We've got over 2,000 Somalians, you know.
Wubba hey.
Yourself, Pally. Oh, we don't want to watch, do we? No. Don't think so. And what's Junior doing anyway? Junior is fast asleep. God bless him. When's his school? His school starts shortly. Class in 7 hours. 8 till 3. And it's now 1 o'clock in the morning. Okay, so he gets a good night's sleep. Mum and Dad are occupying themselves happily, so... poor Justin. Where are you, Justin? I need you, mate. Sounds good. So... I think my tea went cold. Did you serve me a cold cup of tea? Poisoning. That's what it is. She's trying to poison me to get my money. That's what it is. What money? I've got a fiver in my wallet. Didn't you know about that? Hey? Hey? Oh, sorry. Just... Oh, crikey Moses. What have I done? Poor chap's dying on his feet because he's so tired and hungry and got no fun. And he's... and I've sent him to pick... to pick a brick up. Where's Justin going? He's going to bed. Don't blame him. He's had a hard, busy night. So, sounds good. -3, -10 units, -3. What's that mean? I don't know what that means. Let me just pop into that one. Right, I do go rambling on from time to time, and I'm so worried about people ask questions or they make a comment and I don't get to read it, so I do have to keep nipping up and down the chat bit of it now and again. So how long do you usually stream for? Probably till about 6 o'clock is normal for me. I think most of the my followers will agree with that. It's usually about 6. It depends what the topic of conversation is at the time when I'm due to finish. But sometimes I'll go on till about 6:30 if I feel that is the way to go. I don't like to leave mid-conversations or anything like that. So, energy. Come on then, Sophie. You need to get that toilet cleaned. It looks disgusting, girl. I'll get Annika around. She's good. She'll clean it. Very good like that. And Bendy Max, get your breakfast. Oh, excuse me. Come over all tired. And Bendy Max is getting his breakfast. Howard, friend, did you put any milk or sugar in your tea? I'm diabetic, so I don't have any sugar in my tea. I have a sweetener, which... I've forgotten where you said you're from, Dexicon. Are you in England? You're in UK, yeah? I get a sweetener from Tesco, which has got sucralose as its sweetener, because I don't like the other one, which is aspartame or aspartame. Basically, because when they make aspartame, I'm led to believe, and what I found out on Google, is that aspartame is made from the feces excreted by the E. coli virus. I don't know if to believe that, but certainly there's no smoke without fire, and I won't have aspartame for that reason. And if it is right, then yeah. But I do have milk in my tea and the sweetener rather than sugar itself. So yeah. Okay, yeah, it might have got moved at some point. Oh, no, we can get down the back of it, look, there's room. Never mind, a little bit of movement, it's not going to hurt, thank you for that. Good observation, 10 out of 10 for observation. Yeah. They normally stand at the end of the bed and wave their arm in the air if they can't get round, but I think both of them have been in bed before. Depends what it is they're doing, of course, which they need to get there for. So, young chappy. Oh, I knew I was going to test. Sophie, take a pregnancy test. Da 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 da. What will it be? Yes or no? Sophie's not pregnant. Maybe next time. Oh well. Justin, you're firing blanks, mate. Poor Joe, tell him. Is he streaming now? Tell him. Go on to his stream and say, I'm going to do it myself. Oh, poor Justin. I really feel sorry for the bloke, you know? He's going to go onto his stream tomorrow and he's going to try to get 200 females pregnant as quickly as possible. And there he is with his the girl of his dreams, Sophie. And he just failed miserably. Oh, that's a good idea, Sophie. Yeah, Kate, stay away from me. I would if I were you. Hey, gosh. None of this hanky-pankying business. It's, oh, clicked the wrong button there. Yeah. And you're from Norway, that's good. I read that bit and same. And what countries have I visited? Oh, wow. You got a long list coming up because I've been a lot of places. I'm very fortunate. And my father was in the Royal Air Force when I was very small, very young. So we've been to Egypt, we've been to Singapore, we've been to Aden. We've been Singapore, Salita in Singapore. And we've been to Holland, we've been to Germany, we've been to France, I've been to France, I should say. We've been to Northern Ireland and Southern Ireland and where else? Oh, I don't know. It's so many places in the world I've visited. I'm very fortunate, really am. And most of the time, and I say that most of the time, I've thoroughly enjoyed the travels. Since I've been sort of an adult and arranging holidays for myself into Portugal and Malta, just as a holiday resort type thing. I've seen quite a few of them. Countries I'd like to visit, one is America, US of A. Heard so much about America from various sources, Yellowstone movies and what have you. And also so many of my friends as well on Twitch here while I'm streaming, a lot of them from America. And I joke around and laugh a little around. I've got friends in the village where I live in Lincolnshire who are American. And I get sort of all sorts of tales and stories about them. And, to be honest, it's... I'm very lucky. I'd love to go to America. I'd also like to go to Sweden as well. And Finland to see the ice hotel as well, the ice hotels they have there. So, yeah, it's... even though I've done a lot of travelling, there's still places in the world you want to see. I'd like to go and sit on the moon sometime as well, just joking apart, just to have a look at the Earth from a distance like that. Sounds pathetic, doesn't it? Because the chance of that happening is pretty nil. But you asked the question, where have I visited? And in with that goes, where would you like to visit? So, that's another country. I used to work at a holiday camp here in the UK called Butlins. And while I was working at the Butlins at Clacton-on-Sea in Essex, I happened to cross two guys there who were from New Zealand. One was called Earl Brunton and the other was Carol Weber. Or was it Earl Weber and Carol Brunton? I can't remember now, it's too long ago. But they're both from New Zealand, and the picture they painted It's just an awesome thing, and of course we see it here on the TV where oh, thank you, Justin. Have you come over to my Twitch as well? I hope so. Justin, where are you, bud? Yeah, you are. Justin's there and he's there. God bless you, sir. Listen, mate. You know, occasionally one has to break news to a pal, and it's always that bit difficult, you know, and it's sort of... it's against everything that you stand for, and you sort of struggle to find the words. Do you know what I mean? I'm struggling to find the words, and I don't know how to break it to you, so you just tell me when you're ready, and I'll... you need to be sitting down with a good glass of something strong in your hand, because it's really a blow, this devastating news I've got for you, mate. Whenever you're ready, if you're there. But I'd like to go to New Zealand. That's another one of the things. Australia, I would love to see Ayers Rock in Australia. Oh, you're ready in the city. Listen, mate. Well, should I tell him or not? I got to tell him now, haven't I? Listen, Justin, pal, friend, mate, buddy. Justin and Sophie just got together to make a baby. And he failed. I'm sorry. It didn't work, mate. I can't put it any other way. You know, it's just it didn't work. What can you do? Can you give me some advice on this? It's terrible. Am I sterile? I hope not. I'll tell you what, look, let's see. Wrong one, sorry, mate. But it's more choices. Romantically, more choices. Try for a baby. Go for it, Justin, go on. Kids are off to school, the house is yours, yeah? Justin, back in playing with food, come on. Just talk to your wife. this isn't going to affect you, I'm sure it's not. Look, you're going to get a second chance, mate. You get a second bite of the cherry. I was going to say second bite of the cherry there, but I'm going to be careful what I'm saying, because American doesn't always translate well into English. He's apparently a bad cook. Well, I don't know, because, you know. Look, there's little hearts coming up from the bed. Isn't that cute? Quality's good there. What's this one? Excellent quality. I can't. Oh, that was made by Sophie Elizabeth. Elizabeth, I should say. What did he do with that bowl he had just now? Did he take it to bed with him? That's a good to stop. It's the best way to be. Children will be children. Nothing wrong with being honest and open. A guy on a pink bike. Don't be sad. Look at the positive side of impotency. Come on, what positive side of impotency? Ah, oh, dear. Come on, Sophie. Get out of that. Get out of... Come on. Pregnancy test time. Come on. We've got to get Justin back on his feet again. Well, you know what I mean, back on something again. Is he going to need Viagra, or is he just going to have to... Congratulate... Oh, hey, mate, congratulations, you're going to be a dad again. It's... that's really cool. You've exonerated yourself now. Have you guy on a pink bike? Come on then. Are we going to get a list or? She's looking as though she's. You're looking swell, Sophie. You can tell, Sophie. Yeah, she's looking good. The only thing is, Justin, and I don't think you realised it before you jumped into bed with Sophie, is that you certainly did. Yeah. 2 out of 199. Do you count this one? Can you count this one? I guess you could, couldn't you? Really? Hey? Speak to me, Justin. You could, couldn't you? You can have this one. We'll ship it over to your Sims account as soon as possible. As soon as it's born, I'll email it to you, okay? Trouble peeing in the morning due to... with no more. Okay. no more. Yeah. I think as you get older, you you don't realise how many complications can be in just going to the toilet, you know? It's... I don't want to go into too many details, but gosh, I wish I had a... They say go to the toilet is spending a penny, you know. I wish I had a penny for every time I'd visit. My Christ, I wouldn't need any pension at all. I'd be living off the money. Anyway, we'll change the subject now. Not yet, but soon. Maybe I could know. That's genius. I'll put a character in the gallery with a message. Many kids, and have them message me, count them all, kids all over the world. Absolutely spot on, mate. Absolutely, that's the way we've discovered. Right, what we have to do is get onto the sim people, get onto the gurus, and say what we'd like is an interactive multiplayer game, please. So as my wife actually suggested, or somebody suggested earlier on, that we have a two-way stream. And we look at, you know, both of our maps and we both stream together. Better if it'd be on the same map, wouldn't it? Because we could interact each other's families. Yeah, there's so many pros for it. How many cons for it? I can't think of one. So there we go. Sim Gurus, if you're listening to this, and if you'd play it back on YouTube, hopefully you will. Or I might even make mention when I go to Twitch next time, because I've got a few Sim Gurus on my... follow list on Twitch. So these we really need that. This is, I know you tried, you did do a Sims Online once and that was really good and it was very clever, but then you stopped it. I believe you stopped it. I don't know for sure, but I've not seen it around. You certainly don't advertise it if you haven't stopped it. So Sim Gurus, please, multiplayer game. Up to 3 or 4 people even. Doesn't have to be 6 or 10 people. We're not into that. It's basically, we just need a multiplayer game. So we can have 2 of us playing on the same map or 2 maps next to each other, you know, and visit each other through the map. That's what we need. Okay? Sorted. Yeah, kids all over the world, Justin. Man, that's... I watched a film last night and I can't for the life of me remember what it was called. I might be able to find out for you if you bear with me a minute second. Yesterday, that will be the one. And that will take us up to somewhere stupid late at night. It's a 9 o'clock film. The Delivery Man, that was what it was called. 2013. I don't know if you've seen that movie, Justin, or if you've heard of it, but The Delivery Man, 2013, look it up on the database, the IMDb. But it's about some guy who's a sperm donor, and all of a sudden his, I think it was 533 children, managed to track him down as to, you know, the fact that he's a father. Now, I think the courts were after him for alimony and child maintenance fees, so it could be rather expensive for him. However, you need to watch the film to find out how it came out if you haven't already seen it. Sort of film I feel you would enjoy, so look it up, mate, have a look. It was a very good movie. Yes, it was. It's I laughed at it. I don't know whether it's a topical thing or whatever, but it's a well-made movie. It's well put together and sort of answers a few questions you never even thought of asking. So, wicked stuff. The Delivery Man, 2013. I can't remember who it starred, actually, so I'll pop back very quickly. Oh, my mouse has died. No, it hasn't. I've just got it. Blitzgirl05, welcome and thank you very much for the follow. That's exceedingly nice of you to do that. That makes me feel really like I'm doing the right job, you know? And it's all down to you at this moment in time. So thank you very much, Blitz Girl. Absolute star. Let me go back to what I was trying to do, is find out the people who are in the movie The Delivery Man, which was on RTV just last night. And it was Chris Pratt and Kobe Smulders. Smulders. And Vince Vaughn, whoever they are. But it's a man who made regular donations to a sperm bank 20 years ago, discovers he's fathered over 500 children. That's the one. Excellent movie. If you get a chance to watch it, do that, because it'll make you laugh, if nothing else. I see you playing guitar. Yeah. Yes, I do. And Justin, you had to remind me, didn't you? Hey, you had to remind me of that little thing. I've made a promise to people, followers, that when we get to 250, is it? Or was it 300, Justin? Have you got the numbers right there, mate? I'm sure it's 900. Positive. Was nine? Was it 1,000? I can't remember now. But I've got to play the guitar live. That same tune that I recorded as my welcome and thank you tune. I used to have John Denver singing the song "Follow Me" on there, but I got a bit worried about copyright infringement and that sort of thing. Which technically it was. Having said that, whenever it was played, I always made a point during the stream that I would give the recognition to John Denver's the people. You better grab that guitar. Yeah, I'll let you see my guitars. I'll take a photograph of my guitars and you can have a look at them in picture form to start with, because they're really something else. Well, they're not. They're actually guitars and not something else at all. But I'm rather proud of my little collection. There's only four, but it's really cool stuff. Justin, you heard it was 200. I don't know where you got that number from. I'm almost sure it was a 1,500. 15 rings a bell. Yeah. Because I'm not brilliant. Not, you know, I don't know what you're expecting. It's if you're waiting for, I don't know, Mark Knopfler or something like that, you're in for a good old disappointment. Pleased to say that. But, you know, that's the standard. That's as good as it got on there. That was after 20 takes as well, I have you know. 20 times I played that through before I settled on that one. Now, whether it was because I settled because that was the best, or settled on it because I didn't really want to do it again, I really can't say. But, it's... do you want to invite a classmate over? Yes, why not? Do it. Go for it. TV's fixed. I bet it was a remote control that was broke as well. Have you ever noticed that in The Sims? Whenever the TV breaks, or a computer, or the stereo, it is always this remote control that plays up. Right, who's that? A friendly introduction. There you go. Hello, mate. How are you? Oh, I'm fine. I'm a bit outside at the moment. Hey, little man, how are you? I'm fine, thanks. Whoopee, I'll wave. That'll do. Right, now, Sophie, what's happening? Yeah, we'll do, and I shall be watching. I'll be there for you tomorrow, mate, when you start your, well, we've started, haven't we? We've got you at least one kiddie already, but when you start yours in earnest, then we'll be there with you, mate. And I hope Ernest doesn't mind at all. So donate. Weihoofd. Yeah, wonderful. Yeah, could get a donation. I'm thinking I'm doing a 12-hour stint on Sunday, this coming Sunday. Still in its infancy yet, because I haven't decided whether I want to do that. But the other thing is to do is maybe I could do that for a charity cause. We have a lot of cancer charities. One in particular that is a personal friend of mine, and his wife started off. She got cancer of the stomach at some point and had to have a major operation, but she got over it.
and had a lot of support of the local cancer specialist, which I can't remember what they're called because my brain's fading fast. Oncologist, I think it was called. So yeah, there's a lot of deep feeling going on there, and Jim and June have been friends of mine for probably as long as I've lived in this neighbourhood, which should be close on 20 years, I suppose. And I always swore blind that if we could help them, we would. So maybe a charity bash on Sunday would be good, and get some donations towards them. Might be really good to do that. I don't know how they'd feel about it. I haven't approached them on it. But there again, it could always be something for later on. I don't know. That's cool. It's quite a responsibility, I think, when you lay on something like that, especially for friends, that you do it properly and make sure that you've dotted the I's and crossed the T's, so to speak, when you're doing that sort of thing. But I'm sure that a lot of my followers would go along with that, because I wouldn't say they're charitable people, all of them. I wouldn't know that, and I wouldn't presume to know that. But certainly the way people talk on my stream, there'd be a lot of sympathy for that sort of cause. Anyway, that's coming events, not necessarily right now. And so we have now Sophie, who's with child. And Justin, who is a child, he likes to think, but Justin's at work till, I don't know, some silly hour, 1 o'clock in the morning, is it, Justin? Yeah, 1 a.m. He's still only a head dishwasher, and he's not particularly a good one. Oh dear. Prepare food and mix drinks. Okay, we need to get him a bar maybe to practice his drink mixing routine. We also need another bedroom. I think we need to make some alterations to the property before Bentley Max Junior 2 is available or whatever child it happens to be. We have to look to building at least another room on the house, although there is room for one here, especially if we put a partition in the bathroom. We could have a small bedroom, maybe put the two single beds in there. Be company for little Bentley. That'd be cool. Don't know, just pull that out a bit. So you've got to be careful about how much money we're spending as well, because they haven't got a whole lot of money. So we could also close this gap up, make it into a little cube, couldn't we, the house? But I don't know. We should send him in a better mood. Yeah, see, with me gas in here and sitting here talking too much, I'm pretty convinced that the last twice that he's gone off to work, I didn't even notice him going, to be truthful. So I'm just a bad person manager. And I take your point, Mima. Wrap myself across the knuckles and tell myself to pay more attention, boy, because your Sims are suffering because of my inability to maintain a decorum around the property. So there we go. We'll accept that as a telling off. But quite right. No, you shouldn't send somebody to work in starving, hungry. He's dying on his feet. He's starving, hungry. Not good, is it? Not really. So I'll write out 100 times, you must pay more attention to the game, Howard. Oh, what's this? Yeah, I certainly wouldn't like to go to work with my energy in the red levels. Who was that just followed me? Ms. Shannon, thank you very much for the follow. And please feel free to join in the chat, certainly, if there's anything you'd like to comment on or advise me with. I need advice because I've just sent somebody to work. And they're dying on their feet, they're starving, hungry. And I had no sympathy for him. It's only Justin, though, so that's all right. Justin doesn't mind. Justin's perfectly happy. However,
His wife Sophie is expecting their second child together, which is brilliant. This is son number one, Bentley Max, who's running away from home with an orange juice in his hand. He's gone to see his mate, saying, "Here, you ordered this, you blasted well, drink it, bud. You can't just order stuff and leave it lying around, it's bad." Okay, it's gone. Oh no, who's that? Shelley Holloway, of course it is. Oh, can't do that. Sorry, Justin, you're at work, mate. Don't talk to strangers. Someone might be kind and muddle up your mind. So, I'm very well, Miss Shannon. Yeah. Had a good stream so far. Plenty of interaction with my followers and plenty of advice and all the nice things you want in life. They're all being delivered to me today for some reason. I must have done something maybe right. I'm not saying necessarily in this lifetime, but something somewhere was right. Right, run over the family with you, certainly. So we know that it's Justin who's... Justin is staring, really. This is a character Justin made and allowed me to use. There's also another famous lady here. And that is Sophie, who is Justin's wife. And she... the character was made by Complexi... can't remember the numbers, Complexi. 990, was it? I'm sure it was, yeah. Anyway, that's it doesn't matter. But those are the characters that were made for me, and I've put them together because they're an ideal couple. But the story attached there, if you want the story, Miss Shannon, I'll tell you gladly. Basically, Justin was married to another, to Chloe, on a bit further up the map. And then Sophie, his long-lost girlfriend, came back into town. And Justin realised that his love for Sophie was greater than his love for Chloe. So sadly, they had a divorce in The Sims, obviously. And Justin and Sophie got married. And out of the marriage came little Justin Jr., called Bentley Max, who's their first child off the union. And just recently they have decided to raise the family again by another 25% indeed, to make it a foursome rather than a threesome. Now, is that raising it by 25% or 33 and a third? I don't know, not very good at maths. But anyway, that's what they've done. This is the state of play so far. So I hope that that you don't feel as though you're missing anything. But sometimes this stream, it can get worse than Peyton Place or all them. Oh dear. What were they called? I can't remember the name of the shows they used to watch, but there was Peyton Place and there was the Colbys and Dynasty, or Dynasty, depending what side of the pond you're on. Yeah, so all those, and it all happens here, you know. We try to keep it under control where we can, but sometimes it just gets away from us, you know. What is the matter? Sophie, just go fix the fridge. Don't argue. Just, gosh, you're hungry. Okay, so you're hungry, but it's pointless being hungry if the fridge is on fire, you know. Ooh, did she throw that open in temper then? I'm sure she did. So when poor Justin, look, we need to get him fed and watered and get his nose bag on and make sure that everything he's doing is right, because the poor chap's been to it was pointed out to me, the poor chap's been to work with no fun, very little energy, starving, hungry, and probably filled in the bladder as well. So we have to really pay a bit more attention to him. My admonishment has certainly worked. How is she doing in handiness? She's only level one. Oh dear. Oh, she's fixed loads of stuff. I don't know why she's only level one. She's the backbone of the family in fixing stuff. How long have you been playing The Sims for?
About 6 weeks, I guess. I've had the game. It was bought to me when it first came out in probably, I think it was about February last year. But I was working then, and unfortunately I didn't get a chance to look at it properly and play it properly. So since I retired, I decided what I'd do is get into a game more and start streaming it a bit more. So it's going good, and I'm thoroughly enjoying it. And my followers so loyal that they keep coming back, and occasionally somebody will suggest something which means that we can create another story and do scrambled egg. Actually, no. Whew, yes, okay, sorry about that. Could have done with Justin doing the cooking there, because yeah, he needs the points for work. He's a head dishwasher, but he really needs to get some stuff going. Where's he going now? Oh, he's going for a shower. That's okay, because that's where I was going to send him next anyway. So, there we go. That's the answer to your question. Playing Sims for about 6 weeks. Although I have played a little bit before, but so much little bit that it's hardly worth worrying about. Go and hit it with a bigger hammer. Shh, nobody's looking. Quick, get it out. And Bentley Max is laughing his head off at his mum's attempt to cook food. Where are you going, little one? You going to school? Oh, poor Bentley Max. Oh, he's gone to play in the rubbish. Okay. Oh, right, okay. What a lad, what a star. Bentley Max, grab a serving. Come on, boy. You'll be going to school soon. And you, Justin, you need food as well. There you go, bud. Grab a serving. He'll go and eat it on his bed, won't he? Almost certain. Good lad. There's Bentley Max. Yep. Trying to get Justin's mood up. I tell you what, now I've done all that, I bet he's not even working. 3 days, he's got, oh dear, all that work. We'll find him something to do around the house.
What's next? Thelma!
Alright. No, it's okay. Do you want to take over the stream for a minute while I go and visit the bathroom? You could do. You could just take over. Nobody notice. I just think my voice has changed a lot. Put a mask over the front of the camera and they wouldn't see you. They'd just think, oh, your voice has gone terrible, Howard. What's the matter with you?
Terrible.
Yeah. Well, not really. It's just different. That's what I mean. Different. What's this? Ah, right. Cool. I barely played the Sims. I'm going to never get the time. Two kids that just moved in with me from Australia and New Zealand, so it's hard. Oh, it's 5 a.m. in the morning, and you're sitting up watching me streaming. We were actually, Miss Shannon, now I'll just say this, because I'll say it quite openly to you. We were just discussing with can't remember who it was now, somebody. Oh dear, I think it was, yeah, I'm sure it was J-Bite. I can't see now, but I think it was J-Bite. We were discussing places where I'd been to in the past. And the country where you're at in New Zealand is just one of those places we'd just love to go. And it's very fortuitous. Thank you very much for turning up from that far away. And at 5 o'clock in the morning, that is awesome. And I really, really hope you do get a chance to play it, because it's so relaxing and rewarding at the same time as well. We have little scenarios going. Without boring you too much, but we have Bill Gates on the map. Would you believe Bill Gates? And he lost his money by virtue of an accident. Well, it wasn't an accident. He lent the money to me and I spent it. So now he's stuck with a little plot. However, he's working his way up, earning money from the garden. And he's
apparently he's quite good with computers, it has in the game, so we're letting him be a techie and doing that. But his wife is looking after the garden, she's a level 10 gardener. Additionally, we have Justin here with Sophie, who long lost lovers reunited, as I said before when you first came in. You've heard the story on them, but there's other stories around. There's several of the yeah, he did. He lent it to me. He said, "Here, Howard." Well, no, I'll tell the truth. Now, I went on. I said, "Bill, can you lend us some money?" He says, "Buddy, you can take all of it for me." So I did. But then I had a little bet with the man. He had two snails, quite big snails as well. One was a brown one and one was a beige one. And I said to him that the brown one was faster. He said, "Nope." I said, "It is." He said, "Nope." He said, "How much do you want to bet?" So I said, "All this." And I was wrong. Dear, dear, what's the matter with Sophie? What happened, Soph? Hey? Do you need a shower, maybe? I suspect you do. Yeah, took my mind off again, didn't I, Mimo? Oh dear, I'm terrible. Yeah, so Bill lost all his money. Just cut the story short. He lost all of his money and... hey, Justin. What a gent, eh? Throw your wife out of the shower because she was black and jump in yourself. Never mind. I'm not paying attention, really. Yeah, so we've got all sorts going on the map. Most of the people you see in the game are likenesses of my followers. I went through a period where when somebody followed and they gave me permission to create a character for them, we made a character and let them come on the map. So we have a nice variety of people and it's really, really nice, some of them. No, that's a lie. All of them are. Casey Lynn, hello. You hear it. Why is it? Casey Lynn, I'm shouting at you now. This is it. You're in trouble. Why is it you always come to the end of one of my streams? Every time. Now, you're a bad girl. What are you? You're a bad girl. That's correct. But yeah, God bless you for turning up anyway. And just for those who don't know it, Casey Lynn was probably one of my original streamers, followers on stream. So I have a lot of admiration for her. And she's always welcome. She always comes at the end of the stream, though, because I don't get a chance to... dang it. Yeah. Hot diggity damn. South Carolina, I believe that's right, isn't it, Casey Lynn? South Carolina person. We've got people from New Zealand and Australia and Norway and Sweden and Germany and it's a beautiful world, isn't it? Hey, PM me. Private message me.
Samzo.
What do you want private messaged? A whisper. I'll throw a whisper. Oh, whatever. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's me, Adolf. Oh, right. It's me, Adolf. Don't know who to PM you, but I've sent a... Hey! That's pretty good, isn't it? That's a good message, that. Hey. Even spelled it right as well, which is different for me. I'm thinking that maybe Miss Shannon is saying things like, "I didn't mean you, I meant, do you bite?" That's right, it's me, Adolf. Yeah, it probably is, actually. Okay, so sorry about that, Miss Shannon. I just assumed you meant me. I do apologise. Well, anyway, Casey Lynn, we'll come back to you and try to hide the embarrassment. Like the Sims get when they get a bit of embarrassment. There isn't a little button to press to get over it. So, no worries. I guess we have here Sophie, who you've seen before, Casey Lynn. Sophie is with child, in case you didn't notice. She hasn't just swallowed pickled onions or anything like that. This is genuine. She's having a baby by Justin again. This is child number two, bless them. Are they going to kiss? Yes, of course they are. When they stop watching telly. I want to tell you a story about a robot, is that? Yeah, okay. Whatever. So I guess next time we come on, which will be Friday before I stream again, I guess that Sophie will have had the child, the second child, but I hope we can be around when it happens, because I want to give it a name, not like some of the names that Sims tend to throw on you. You got an 8-month-old that's teething. We've been there, we've seen it, we've done it. We've got the t-shirt, read the book. In fact, we wrote the book, I think. What can you say? Teething gel and cuddles, that's what cures teething. It's a little bit of teething gel, not too much. Late at night, of course. You know Adolf in real life? Oh, okay, that's cool. I'll close that window because I don't know if you want this information being put on the channel, so I apologise if you didn't, but hey, it's out there now. Right, so what was I saying there? I can't remember now. Can you remember what I was talking about? The brain just died, I think. I think the fuse just blew. Yes, so, yeah, we'll have the baby, hopefully, but some of the names that Sims, the game, throws on these children is not fun. I'm just going to take a very quick natural break. Da-da-da-da-da-da. And there we are, back again. See, I told you it wouldn't take long. Never does. Unfortunate thing. No, he wakes me from... hospital recovering, okay. Right. What can I say? You know, that's magic. What are these two up to? Oh, what? Oh, I don't think we ought to be watching this. Not if... yeah, okay, this is where we'll avert our eyes. It's children at school, isn't it? So that's what it's about. Justin, you reprobate you. It's you're a bad lad. What's this? Pregnant? Second trimester, that's cool. Invigorating shower, which she's had now, I think. A secret revealed from socialisation. I'm giddy with excitement. I like the sound of that one. And watch the romantic comedy. That's going to keep her happy for 3 hours. It must have been good. Get married to Justin. They are married. They are married, aren't they? I'm sure they're married. Yes. Yeah, we had a big marriage wedding for them. Okay, be friendly. We can do that. Ask somebody to go in steady. They've got these... mixed up, surely. There's some... how ridiculous. They're already married. You can get married again if you want, but it's a bit of a waste of money because you're already there. Certainly it should be. I mean, there's a second child on the way, for heaven's sake. What are you thinking? Da 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 da. So we're here again. We're back where we started, really, just in on the sofa, and Sophie eating for two, as they say. What's Justin doing? Let's have a look at Justin again. He's okay now. See, that's a good way to go to work, isn't it? But he doesn't need to go to work today. He doesn't need to go to work for a few days, in fact. Three. Ah, dear. And what's that say? It's inspired is the ideal mood for work. So if you can get him inspired somehow, but he's got very little in the house to inspire him unless we make a few alterations to the property. Derek Chan, good afternoon, Derek. How are you, my friend? I didn't miss you earlier on. I think you popped on while I was having my break to collect my son from college. I think you popped on then. I did see you, mate, and I did acknowledge the fact once I got back to streaming. So sorry I missed you earlier on. That's cool. And here's Sophie, who's I miss you. Yeah. Is that aimed at me, Derek? Yeah, I'm good. It's been a wonderful afternoon. Lots of things we've done that we've been happy about. We stayed with the Gates family earlier on and tried to get Bill a bit more of his money. He's got I think 70,000 now in the bank, so he's well on the way to getting enough money to make a million. We've got to concentrate on the garden a bit more so as we can get better money and better quality plants. Sophie, can you just nip outside, please, my dear? And pick up the rubbish. Thank you very much. Oh, dear, it's a bit pongy, that is. Throw it away. And likewise, that one. And then that one. Oh, dear. What's little Bentley Max watching on television? Who's that? That's Freya, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Freya Anderson. What are you doing round here, Freya? Eh? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. We'll do a friendly invitation. Yeah, I don't know if... Freya's not on. What a shame, because last time she saw a character... In fact, the first time she saw a character, she had blonde hair. Because that's the way I created her. This is one of the characters, Mrs. Shannon, that I created for one of my followers. And it is, in fact, Freya Anderson, who's one of the followers. And when she saw it, she says, oh, I like her. She's, you know, pretty close. But she did have brown hair and not blonde hair. So we've had to make reparations. And she's looking good on it. So there we go. It's always good stuff. Try to be as accurate as we can if we've got anything to go by, but it doesn't always work out every time. Sometimes you get a bit wrong, and like I say to all my followers, if I do make a character of you, and I've either made it too large or too small as well, because that upsets people, if you make them too skinny, and they're like a little stick insect, people get upset by that. Likewise, colour of hair and stuff, and... Here's Twiglet. What's Twiglet doing? Bite in. So, in fact, I haven't seen Twiglet all afternoon. Wonder what's happened to her. Let's check everywhere. No, she's gone off. Mind you, I did upset her a bit. I think she used to be a moderator, and I took her off moderating because I had too many moderators. So I think she might be a bit upset with me. Hopefully it'll pass. Hope so. So, there we go. Anyway, this is... right, as I said, there's Twiglet Carson, and there's Freya Anderson, and Sophie Elizabeth, who's fast asleep on the settee, but probably good reason to be, because she's expecting Justin Staring's second child. There's Bentley Max, their first child. So, that's everybody in the household. It's really cool. Yeah, wonderful stuff.
Sugar fish, yikla, yabah. Shaogo Gumpy Quartz.
Floopy.
What do you saw?
Oh, Zag.
Levitate board.
Spinosa Batanabe?
Zofula.
Kyabo.
Ah.
Bombzoid Dimpish. Sistoon Turib. Pipidow.
Snivara Watanini. Lumina Exene.
A little Bentley there. You know, for a Sims reconstruction, Sims child. Very much like his dad, you know, I mean, it's got to be in the trait of the family, isn't it? That, yeah, they just got to. What's he eating anyway? It's pinks and blues and oranges and whites. Yeah, rainbow breakfast, I think. So what have we got? Oh, right here. Hey, so I'm going to go. I will see you on Friday. You say, Auf Wiedersehen, liebe ich alle, gesund bleiben. Sorry, don't fully understand that because my German is rubbish, I'm afraid. But we can copy it. We can paste it into the translator. And then maybe you said something nice. Who knows? Goodbye. Love you all. Stay healthy. Oh, that's... vielen Dankeschön. And likewise to your good self as well. It's nice to have you on board as a follower, and we look forward to seeing you on Friday, and we'll see if we can get some interesting conversations going. So have a good day. Guten Tag. Hope everything goes well with you. So there we are. What time is it now? It's 6:05 turned in the UK. Living just on the east coast of the UK in Lincolnshire. That's where we're at, if anybody's curious enough. Sort of hoping that Sophie would give birth before we go offline. Oh, right, Technicolor yawn. That's beautiful stuff. Ah, don't you just love it when they throw up in the toilet? Aye. Sorry, taking the mic again, aren't I? Alright, clean. Come on, Sophie. Sophie. Get yourself down there and get it sorted out, girl. You made the mess, you clean it up. Justin ain't gonna help. You too, goodbye, everybody. I'll see you later, Jebite, anyway. Yeah, have a good day. Yay, befriended with Bentley Max. That is your next job. Excuse me. Oh no, is he off to school? No, he's not. Surely not. Bentley Max, stand still, boy. I'm such a fidget. Oh dear, what should we do to brighten his day? Brighten his day is a good choice, isn't it, eh? Gosh, it's a bit obvious, but there we go. Hopefully that'll be one of our aspirations. God. And get engaged. This is ridiculous. Get rid of it. Chat with Bentley Max. We can do that. We can chat with Bentley Max. Express love and enthusiasm about New Zealand. What choices? Diddle it friendly. Ask about school. That's chatting, isn't it? Surely it is. Or maybe it's got to have that perfect button. And there's Justin gone for a lie down again. Playful. Be funny with Jay. Okay, that'll be Jay Huntington, whatever, yeah. Discuss fine cuisine. And tell a joke from being happy, okay. Once upon a time there was 3 bears. Now look how many there are. That's funny. Okay. Hello, White Witch. White Witch 2, welcome to the stream. And that was... That's my wise bot in action. Tells me who's joined the stream, in case you were wondering. But welcome anyway. And if you you want to have a chat, then feel free to join in. Please, please do. We'll be we're sort of going shortly, I'm afraid. So I don't know what to say. But never mind. We're here for a minute or two, so you can get to listen. And if you like us, you can come back another time. But no worries. There's Twiglet just going home now. Bye, Twiglet. And there's Sophie, who's with child, as they say, having some cereals. What a busy household this will be. Ooh, we have to buy some more beds as well before I forget, because we have another... Well, I suppose we've got a few days once the baby's born, because it'll be living in one of them crib things, won't it? Hmm. So, yeah, could really do with a bigger house, I think. That is the truth of it all, because it's just getting really crowded. I have moved the walls slightly so as to allow for a bit of expansion in here, so but it'd be a very, very small room, which is maybe not ideal. Can't do much here because of the door taking up some... We can always make it a smaller door, or even bring the doorway out a bit. Let's do that. How much does that cost us? Oh, we gained money. That's okay then. Oh, we should have done that sooner, shouldn't we? Oops, sorry, didn't mean to do that. And that didn't mean to do. I'm getting mouse happy now. It's too late in the day. Have a window there. Can't afford much, bless them. So this is what we get. So that's made quite a good size room. I'll just... make it a little bit of adjustment to that, so it's a bit smaller there. Don't know quite what's happened. Don't know what's probably something wrong with the building plans there. That can go as well, I think. Not sure about these either. These walls might. It's be a nice little partition there. So I've been clicky with the mouse, which is wrong. It's the right turn, this is. I am now playing Sims. Oh, bless you for that. That's good. You'll be streaming next, Mrs. Shannon. Yeah, you'll be streaming. So get the OBS software off the internet. It's totally free of charge. Get your microphone out, plug it in, and away you go. It's dead easy. Simple as that. And then we can all follow you, and we can all... be watching you play Sims. I thought, and a lot of people commented, you know, it's strange to have an old man on the Sims playing the game and that sort of thing. And I thought, yeah, okay, well, I didn't realise it was that unusual, but, you know, I listened to what's been said. But the other day I was on, it was maybe a week ago now, but I was just looking through things in the night time, and I came across a lovely lady from... she did say the name of the place she was in America. It could have been Florida, actually, but yes, she's a nice lady. She's actually a little bit older than me. I won't give her age out, but she's a little bit older than I am, but she was going good style and playing it and streaming as well at the same time. So God bless her for that, and it just shows, you know, this streaming and Twitch, it's not all to do with young kids and young people. It's all generations of all walks of life, and it's so much fun because you meet so many lovely people. There is a lot of people out there who are just gorgeous people from, you know, start to finish. So yeah, well blessed, really well blessed. Right, okay, that's enough going on at the moment. We're still waiting for the baby to arrive. Just get rid of that doorway for 50 simoleons, because we'll put another little doorway in there, I think. Just a bit narrower. Ooh, that's a bit pricey. Oh, I'll have one of them. There we go, we'll have that one. Who could ask for anything better, eh? That's just so good. There we go, what do we have to hear? Right. What was her Twitch username, if you know, prefer older gamers? Than the younger ones, to be honest. Okay, Just let me think, get the old grey matter churning, and I'll print it up here so you can copy and paste it. But it was S-H-A-R-Y-N, capital P-L-A-Y-S. There we go. Sharon Plays, that's the lady. I don't think she streams very often, but it was very entertaining when I was there. It was very, very entertaining what she was doing. So had a beautiful garden as well. I think she must have had the garden pack on as an expansion. And you looked at the garden. She was placing flowers when I first saw her, and sort of putting a board around the property that she got her a lot. And she was laying the flowers out, and it looked so nice. It's obviously it's only a game, I know, but there's a lot of sort of reality gone there. And she really did. She really she nailed it. If you do go to Sharon, just mention that Howard suggested it to you, Howard Hall. Just so I made her a promise that I would try to mention her whenever I could, without being boring about it. But it'd be nice to know that she knows I'm keeping my word, if that makes any sense to you at all. But yeah, be good if you go there. That'd be good, and wish her the best from me. So, I'll tell you what, I won't move the door at this stage. I'll go back in where I thought I was. Who's that? Who needs a loo? We've got. Oh, come on, Sophie. Have this child quickly. I don't want to leave it to Sims to name it, because they have some rubbish names, I'm afraid. Had one child born recently whose name was Justice. Justice, whatever it was. And I thought, oh no, Justice. Was that a 555? I can't remember now. Kennedy, Justice Kennedy, I think it was. But never mind, we went into The Sims and corrected it a bit. So, how are you doing with your trimester business? Still second trimester? Okay, I'm afraid I have to do this. Just speed it along a bit, because we only have about a quarter of an hour left, and then I have to be other places. Yep, was that it? Was that the third trimester just ticked over? No, it wasn't. Oh, dear. Never mind. Right, I did notice a basin here. Justin, could you please clean with the vigour? I thought it said clean with vinegar then. Seems to be not the popular trait in the household is the neat and tidy bit. I think there's a lot of I'll just leave it, somebody else will clear it up, you know, like our house, I guess. No, that's very cruel. Richie. Who are you watching? YouTube. Okay. There we are anyway, so we're getting there. Right, oh, sure will, thank you. And see if I've got everybody here. Complexy990, you still there? It's good to have you, good to have all these people. And Faegwent as well, that's another one I haven't had a chance to talk to yet. Faegwent suddenly clicked onto my list of viewers, and I think he must have maybe parked on there. Had a look at his bio, and he's got a tremendous amount of followers himself, and I'd be sort of like to just talk to him a little bit, but you know, if he's not here or he's too busy, then it ain't gonna happen in a short while. Not a problem anyway. Another little job I was meant to do while I was in the purchase mode. Let's get another chair for this side of the table. Don't think we can have one on the far side, but little Junior, when he pops along, she pops along, won't need a chair for a day or two, that's for sure. So, White Witch 2, what a little about me, I'm 52, disabled, my origin username is LSAT 555, who wants to take it off? Okay, we might just do that, White Witch. That's very kind of you to give us that information. Health, Hell's Ace 555. Do you want, shall I go there now to have a look? And that way all my followers could see your stuff. Shall I go there? You give them the name, so I don't suppose it would matter much, would it? So go to the gallery. And go on to the community, which will ask me if I want to connect in a minute, won't it? Ah, freezing out. Oh, well, not to worry. I do what I can to not freeze. Right, and here's White Witch 2's gallery. Obviously good at building houses. I mean, that's a nice place, isn't it? Sort of place you would take weeks to build. Gosh, that is nice, actually. Six comments, free to download, wonderful. Yeah, I like that myself. I might come back later on when I've had a jiggle around with my plots and see what else we could have. A good variety of characters as well. Oh, buffing. Yeah, that happens, I'm afraid. Where are you from, White Witch? Do you mind me asking, just to give us an idea? Wow. Some spooky ones there as well. Sorry. Oh, Borden in Hampshire. I didn't see that earlier on. My wife just pointed out. I do apologise. Borden in Hampshire. Why do I know that address? Borden. That's where your dad lives, isn't it? Yeah, could be. Not sure. He might have lived there and then he moved away. So, yeah. Yeah, it is. God, what a small old world it is. Never mind. Oops. Some interesting characters as well. There's no sort of standard, if you like. I'll use the word standard. There's no standard shape or format, is there? They're all different people from different walks of life. That's quite interesting. I don't like the Tragic Crown. Yeah, not my favourite character. Wow, it's full. That's wicked. Thanks for sharing that with us, White Witch. It's good to see you. God, you've been very busy. I mean, look how much stuff she's got as well. You're so busy as well. Spooky Discotheque. What's this one? Blue Jew. Value 11,000. That's quite a cheap place, isn't it? But it's got the office and it's got a bed. It's got a kitchen. No, it hasn't got a kitchen. I can see. Okay, so it's probably just an office anyway. So there we go. And another small bit of accommodation, two bedrooms and a office. Okay. Yeah, a variety of stuff there. Are these individuals' rooms that you put together? I would think that's what we're looking at, isn't it? You'd sort of glue them all together and you've got a nice big property. It's a way to go. Maybe that's what these characters should do in the small house. It's only a tiny place, but it's all they can afford, bless them. They can't afford anything greater. So, right, we're sort of about done then, I think, for today. I'm going to have to go and wrap up about now. Thank you all very much for being there with me this afternoon. Jesse Big Jobs, I'm sorry, I didn't notice you come on, and thank you for being there, it's much appreciated. I don't think I've spoken to you since you followed that afternoon, but it's always good to see you, and always good to have the old friends coming by. So, really, all of you, thank you very much for being there. Unfortunately, we're not going to get to see Sophie give birth today. We're going to have to wait a while, I guess. Where is she, anyway? She's sitting there somewhere, is she? In bed. Right, so I'm going to set Justin on fixing this lavatory, which appears to have sprung a leak again. And as soon as he's done that, I'm going to go. And, oh, I'm glad you enjoyed it. That's rewarding when somebody says that. It makes you feel like you haven't entirely wasted your afternoon. But, yeah, thanks ever so much for being there, Jess. It's good. It's good that you're there. And White Witch as well, thank you for sharing your community with us. It's always good to see other people's stuff, I think, anyway. I mean, it's very easy to say, oh, it's very good to see your stuff, but it isn't. I mean, just it's so much of a different dimension. Some people, obviously, people think in different ways, and to see the different ways that people create characters and the looks they get, that's really good. So thanks for that, White Witch. And all my regulars, if I've forgotten your names, I do apologise. I'll put it down to me getting old, you know. The brain doesn't work no more. It needs oil or something. At least that's what I call beer nowadays. So there we are. But again, thoroughly enjoyable afternoon. I will be back on Friday, probably usual time, around about 2 o'clock. And then I'll have a break between about 3:25 till 4 o'clock. That's UK time. British summer time, it's called, isn't it? Or GMT plus one. So I don't suppose Mrs. Shannon's going to get up, because you're not going to get up 4 o'clock in the morning to watch us, that's for sure. Or earlier, unless she's up late from the night unless she's up late from the night before, which, you know, does happen. But thanks everyone for being there again. Toilet's fixed, baby's not on the way yet, so I guess when we come back in, baby will be a person, and then we'll have to go into the name edit to make sure it's got a nice name. Again, thanks everybody. I'm going now for real. This is me saying goodbye to you all, and happy streaming wherever you are.